Hey guys, what is going on? In this video, we're going to be checking out Apple's AirTag. So I've had this AirTag for a while, I just haven't opened it yet just because I've been waiting on the little cases that I've ordered from Amazon because I wasn't about to spend $30 on a case for it, even though the AirTag costed $30. But I do give Apple props, I have checked out some of the other cases and they actually are really nice for the price point, but I didn't want to spend the same exact cost as the product. But I did get these little silicone grippy things from Amazon. I'll link them below if I remember to show you which ones I got. I think they were like $8 or $9, one of those two for a pack of four, which wasn't bad, but it did take about a month to come in. But without further ado, we can finally check out Apple's AirTag. If you missed my previous video, it was talking about the HomePod Mini, which I recently just got and set up. Also, I did get a new case for my phone. It is the purple one that just came out for the spring edition of Apple's launch. And it is a pretty nice case. It's one of the silicone ones besides it being dirty. But I do like the case a lot. And yeah, I was playing some music on it before I started. But without further ado, let's take a look at the packaging. So on the front, you get the AirTag. You get the little AirTag symbol itself, which is exactly what it is inside of here. On the back, you just see that you require iPad OS with the latest software. My iPhone's on 14.5.1, it's not on 14.6, but it should still work for me. You just need an iCloud account, which you'll attach it to find my iPhone. Replaceable battery to CL2032, which is pretty nice, because you could just literally open it and put a battery right in it. And yeah, so to get it open, you just basically pull the tab at the bottom, and you can be presented inside. Pull it out of this little tray, and you should be presented with it itself. What else is in the box? So you get, of course, the regulatory warranty information, and then you get safety and handling information as well. The nice thing about the AirTag is if you happen to buy one and you try to stick it on someone and they know it's not theirs, your iPhone will actually alert you that it's tracking you. It'll be like AirTag nearby, something like that. But here's the AirTag itself. Just tells you to update and then hold it 2 inches away, 5 centimeters away from the device to start pairing. And follow the on-screen instructions. Let's go ahead and pull it out of its little tray. It's just wrapped in a little piece of plastic. I've seen a lot of people say that this bottom silver piece gets scratched really, really easily. So time will tell of how scratched that gets. I don't think it's really a big deal to get like a piece of film or anything to protect it because it's going to be a device that you use on your keys and stuff. So why protect it from scratches? But let's just go ahead and open it up. And this should start activating it by pulling out the little tab to activate the battery. So that chime is basically the chime that you hear whenever you go to find it. And this does have tracking, so like if I was across the room, I would be able to pretty much just track the device. And it should point me right to the exact location. My iPhone tried to update. But on the screen, it should be pretty similar to any other Apple product. You just hit connect, and then I'm going to name it. It's for my keys. So I'm going to make it custom name. I'm going to put Kia Lanyard because it is going to be on my lanyard. I'm just going to name it Kia Lanyard and then continue. And I could choose a little bit of emoji to represent this AirTag. I'll just do this little flag. So I'm going to use the little flag. So this is what the Find My app looks like for it. You're going to keep on seeing the HomePod thing pop up. I'm sorry. But basically, it just tells you on how far away it is. So if I were to like hold it behind me, for example, it says 3 foot away. If I put it closer to me, it's closer. I can make it play a sound if I really wanted to. And then it just tells you exactly where it is. So if I were to move it around in a circle, it tells you how far away I hold it. I'm holding it up now, holding it down. So basically, it is a pretty neat system of how what they did with it, so it's pretty nice to have on my keys if I do say so myself. But yeah, so if I ever were to lose my Kia keys, I should be able to find it with my AirTag now. And I believe Siri should be able to find it. Find my AirTag. If you just simply ask Siri, and then it's just gonna try to search for it, and then it will go ahead and make a pinging noise. And you're able to just stop it. which is another neat feature. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. It's just a quick little look at the Apple AirTag. I did buy this one, like I said, for my keychain, and just in case someone goes to like steal it or something, because I do leave it laying around some places sometimes, which I know is not the greatest idea, but you always need to find your keys sometimes. But again, I'll see you guys in the next video. Hopefully you enjoyed this one. Hopefully it gave you a little bit of an insight about the AirTag. Sorry about how long it took to film it, but I did have to wait for these ones to come in on the Amazon. But without further ado, bye now.